1/4 of the population have used illegal drugs. There are 750,000 abortions every year. 9 out of 10 have viewed porn on the internet. 1 out of 10 females have been raped. 40% of us have inflicted self-injury. 65% say there is no true religion. With so many questions and so few answers for such a time as this.
Welcome again to Such a Time as This. We're back, me and the girls, and we've got Vicki, and we've got Harriet, and we've got Betty back again. And last month we talked about Betty's book. It says, Darling, Love Me Into Submission. I think I want to kind of continue on with this talk because I think we had some pretty interesting discussions here, and I think it's going to continue. Like I said, we stopped last month about wooing. We said that a woman woos a man. So we're going to start again. But I was looking through Betty's book, and Betty, it was very interesting, some of the things that you were saying this. I'm like, oh, go, girl. So I'm going to read some excerpts out of your book, and then we'll just jump in as we always do and see where this takes us, Betty.
I do
want to say something. Betty really is a miracle today. She just a week ago had major surgery, and she's back with us. So, Betty, I really appreciate that. And we can see the hand of God is really good for you to come back to us after what we put you through.
And take the abuse we're going to give you.
After what we put you through last time, and for your husband to let you come back with us. It just came out of a movie script. Like, do you write love stories for movies or something?
No, I do not.
Well, you should, because this is this. And so, y'all, let me read this. And chapter 3, it says, your hands make my spirit quiver. Now, just that sentence in itself. But I'm going to read what Miss Betty wrote here. This is what you're writing. One shiny day, while relaxing in the comfort of my husband's arms, I said to him, honey, love me dearly. Take me to a place of excellence where your sweetness can abide in me, where the touch of your hands makes my spirit quiver, and your smile melts my heart, and your mouth brings forth wisdom. Darling, your love is ever before me.
Where did you find such a guy?
Yes.
I didn't know they existed.
Oh, yeah, truly he's God sent.
Oh, okay.
Truly
can't argue with that.
Right, yeah. Truly God sent.
And when I read this, I had to stop and say, did you get this out of a romance novel or a movie? And you really said this to your husband?
Yes.
Girl, you should be writing love stories. Okay, and it's like Vicki said, where did you find this man that he makes your... The interesting thing was you said he makes my spirit quiver, not my soul or my flesh, but my spirit quiver. And I was like, okay.
Yeah.
I'm gonna read a little bit more because I hope this has got y'all's attention because it really got mine, and I don't know where we're gonna go, but I'm sure Vicki and Harry, they're already smiling.
Yes.
And it says, now, you said this, your husband tucks makes your spirit quiver and causes you to side straddle hops. I think, I understand that, side straddle hops, that's breakdancing to me, but anyway. A man's love should be for his wife and for his wife only. Now, that's a true statement.
Yes.
She is the laughter of his smile, the hope of his tomorrow, and the light that shines into obscurity. Yeah, now, Betty.
Well, because he is God sent. And our relationship has been such, we always have had open communication. We talked about everything. Mm-hmm. Because he loved God, and he promised me that he would love me as Christ loved the church. Mm-hmm. With that, there was three words that he had broken down to me. Mm-hmm. He said, first, I have to be your savior, your sanctifier, and your satisfier.
That's what the Holy Spirit spoke to you about, a husband, or?
Yeah, this is what my husband told to me.
Oh, your husband told that
to
you?
Yeah, he told that to me.
Say that again. So, you had to be?
Yeah, he told me he had to be my Savior.
Oh,
He has to be my sanctifier.
Oh.
And my satisfier.
Okay.
Okay, now, before you go, I want to get the script. He can't be your Savior. Jesus Christ is your Savior.
But he is. Who God is.
Okay.
He's a little God because of salvation, he has in him what God has. What God has in him.
Imparted.
Right. So that means that whatever situation, whatever concerns I have, I can take it to him.
Right.
So he takes it according to 1 Peter 5:7 and say, casting all your cares upon me, mm-hmm. for I careth for you. Our relationship is such that I can always go to him and talk to him
right.
about anything and everything. Mm-hmm. So then he in turn, understanding that he should love his wife as Christ loves the church, mm-hmm. and he knows that he can't handle the situation, so he takes the situation and give it.
Yeah, so
and gives
I
it
just
to
I mean
God.
I understood what you're talking about, but I just wanted to make it clear mm-hmm. that the only Savior that can take away
yes.
the
correct.
Sins. Yeah, your husband cannot do that for
right.
you.
Correct.
But,
no, correct.
But he is, when you said Savior, it's like a woman can go to, she's in a dilemma, or she doesn't have this, she can go to her husband.
Correct.
That's what you're okay.
Okay.
Right.
In layman's terms, am I understanding this correct? It's like we go to the doctor,
mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
but ultimately, who's the great physician?
Correct.
Yeah. Correct.
Mm-hmm.
That, yeah. I just wanted to clear that up for the people. You know.
Right.
You know that.
Right.
Go ahead.
Right.
Anyway.
And so by him being the sanctifier mm-hmm. To me, it means because he chose me, I'm now set aside. Mm-hmm. I'm different from other women. In fact, I understand it well now
yes.
that he jumped over other women just for me.
Oh, girl.
So then that makes me totally different.
Yes.
It doesn't matter what it looks like on the outside.